This video is going to be around deception, specifically by defensemen. So we'll just get into some of the videos here and break it down. This first one is Chris Russell here with Calgary. As you can see, he's looking for a pass D-to-D, just trying to make this guy bite on it. Quick little escape turn, step around and gone. So a good teaching lesson in that is, as a defenseman, just concentrating on beating one guy. Some of the bad habits that young players bring with them from initiation, novice, Adam, when they're used to taking the puck and skating through the entire other team, is trying to beat too many people. So when teaching some of this stuff, a good key teaching point is just beating the first man and then making a good first pass. This one's really subtle. You have to really watch for it. So here, the Phoenix defenseman's going up the wall with the puck. His forechecker is going to be angling and trying to take away. What you want to watch is the forechecker's stick position. And as a defenseman, you're looking to just move that stick around with some deception. So as he goes up here, right here, you can see he starts to open his skates up a little bit and almost telegraphs that pass is going D to D, which in turn keeps this stick on this side. And then he just makes a little push and goes forward. So pulls that puck across. And as you can see, he's created that separation that he needs to get to center ice and dump that puck in. So just creating a lane for himself. It's a change of speed too. You can see that he's almost in a glide right here, fakes that pass and then goes into a stride and gets to center ice. So subtle deception there. This one's a good pack. This is Troy Stetcher with Vancouver. This was a preseason game. I picked up quite a few things he did well in this game. So the first one here is just a fake shot, step around, find an open lane and make a pass. As you can see, he just freezes this defense, or this forward. He just freezes this guy. You can see his awkward skate positioning here. He was going up this way and now he's trying to recover and turn his skates that way, because you can see that the fake has been made and he's stepping around. So again, just opened up some space for himself. Same guy, this was later in the game, receives a pass up here, fakes a shot, pushes to the outside, gets a pretty good shot on goal, just about scores on that one. And again, same guy, D to D pass, comes over here, small little pump fake right here, pump fake, steps around, opens up a lane for a goal. That one, as you can see, again, just moving sticks in and out of the lanes. These guys, toe caps and sticks. Sticks are here as it rolls forward. Just steps around, makes that pass through. And a lot of that stuff is just due to that pump fake. These guys can't read what he's doing. Pump fake. Step around, a little push to the outside, find the lane through. This one's a really good angle. As you can see here, you've got, I think it's Torrey Krug up at the top, winding up for a shot. You've got the Pittsburgh forward playing a little bit of street hockey goaltender, ready to block this one. So when you think about this, you just think about lanes that puck has to get through, right? So there's a very, very thin lane there that might not be able to get through. So he just takes and fake shot, doesn't have the lane, makes like he's going to the inside with it, and right there you can see that this guy has turned his skates and started biting on this fake to go that way. And then it's just a little push back. And now that lane is open. That lane is fully open for the puck now. So again, just moving shin pads, skates, and stick out of the way, getting shots through. Just about turns into a goal. Not only your stick, but your feet also for deception. So you watch this walk, takes a couple strides, gets going across, a full mohawk here. Being able to mohawk across and rotate at your trunk, keeping your body square, moving your feet, what it does is really throws this guy off. He doesn't know where that pass is going. It can go either way rather than being telegraphed one way or the other. So as he goes across, he just keeps rotating his feet and his body, opens up a good lane. This one, fake shot here, wound up, drops that forward coming out, has a quick look at the puck to get control of it, steps around, head up again, shot through, really good play. This is one of my all-time favorites. This is the Duncan Keith across the blue line. There's a lot of stuff that goes into this one. Gets that puck on a pass, starts dragging it across using the inside edge, fakes a shot right there, which almost freezes this player, and you can see his stick positioning. If we just back it up a little bit, his stick is on this side. Through that fake, the stick gets moved over to this side, and his skates are biased that way. His momentum is headed that direction, and that's where Duncan Keith just makes a little pushback, rides that other inside edge, almost an area chip to himself, steps around. Really good shot. So that's about that's about as high end a skill as you can see in regards to deception across the blue line. But I wish I would have had a couple more clips on deception on retrievals. That's something I plan to do in the future. But this is more based on offensive and a few defensive situations, breakouts and whatnot. But hopefully a good little introduction to some deception and where it can be used in regards to teaching young defensemen. Great, thank you.